Hello, today I am starting one new exercise 9.6 which is based on differential linear equations. Okay, what is differential linear equation? Let us see. Differential linear equation. This is actually these are two types of equations. One is dy by dx plus py is equal to q. Here this p, that means the terms which containing x only, no y, and this is the q which is purely x. It's okay. So that means p and q, the terms which are having the variable x. And second is dx by dy plus px is equal to q, or p1 and q1, because this p1 and q1, they are containing only y, there's no x. Okay. Right, so there are two linear differential equations. We have to arrange the question in the format which is suitable for us for solving it, okay, which is very convenient for us for solving. So how this dy by dx plus py is equal to q, how does it, what is the solution of it? Okay, by the way, the solution of this is equal to y into e to the power p dx is equal to y into e to the power p dx is equal to q into e to the power p dx into dx. Okay, this is the solution of it, and the solution of that is, it's just opposite, x into e to the power p dy is equal to q, or q1 I can write here, q1, this is p1, q1 e to the power p dy and dy. Okay, this is the solution of it, right? So let us find out the solution of this. I am going to derive the solution first. Dy by dx is equal to py is equal to q. Okay. How to derive it? Look at this. Dy by dx plus py is equal to q. This I am deriving. Okay, at the same as the second one. Multiplying on both sides by the function gx. So g of x dy by dx plus py g of x is equal to q into g of x. It's okay. Here we can consider that this term q into g of x, let us consider that this is the term which is the differentiable term of, this is the term of differentiable term of dy by dx into y into gx. Okay, this will consider qx into g of x is equal to qx into g of x is a differentiable term of y into g of x. We will consider. Now let us see what happened. Gx dy by dx plus p into y g of x is equal to dy by dx, may I write here y into g of x. It's okay. Now what happens? G of x dy by dx plus p into y into g of x is equal to the product rule first function, differentiation of second function g dash x plus second function g of x, and differentiation of that is y dash x. Okay. We'll compare the value of y from both sides. So here the value of y is equal to p into g of x is equal to, here the value of y is equal to g dash x. So therefore p is equal to g dash x upon g of x. Is it okay? This is the denominator term and its differentiation is the numerator term. Okay. Integrate both sides. Integrating to it. So what happened? P dx is equal to g dash x upon gx dx. Is that okay? P dx is equal to this gx is 1 upon gx is equal to t, then g dash x dx is equal to dt 1 upon t. So it is, may I write here, write log t. That means it is log gx. Is that okay? Log gx. Because nothing, base is not here, so base will be taken as e. So now the exponential form, from the logarithmic form we want to convert it to the form of exponential form, then what happened? E to the power p dx is equal to g of x. Is that okay? E to the power, this is from the logarithmic to exponential form. Base to the power integration p dx is equal to g of x. This is the value of g of x, and this value will be substituted here. 1. Y1. So y1, when we substitute the value, then what happens? G of x e to the power p dx into dy by dx plus p into y, and g of x e to the power p dx is equal to q and e to the power p dx. Is that okay? Now you can see carefully this term, e to the power p dx dy dx plus p y e to the power p dx. When we use the term as a product rule in differentiation, so when I write this dy by dx, first function y and second function e to the power p dx. Okay, this is the expansion form of it. You can check it. First function, differentiation of second function, plus second function y and differentiation of e to the power p dx, e to the power p dx into p, is equal to q into e to the power p dx. Is it okay? Now again integrate the term. So when we integrate the term, then what happens? This dx will be shifted here, and the integration of this term is y into e to the power p dx is equal to q into e to the power p dx into dx. Okay, plus c, right? The integration of this term, because the differentiated term is this, so its integration is that only, and is equal to integration dx plus c. So that is the formula or general term of linear differential equation, y into e to the power p dx is equal to q into e to the power p dx dx plus c. Okay, and this term e to the power p dx is called integrating factor, if. What is it? This is if. Okay, clear? So this is the derivation of the formula. Once again, let us see. This is a formula, this is a linear differential equation. We have multiplied by g of x. There are different function can be multiplied to both sides. It's okay. After that, what I have considered, that suppose this is the term which is the differentiated term of y into g of x. Differentiated term of y into g of x. It can be, I think we can select a term which can be differentiated, and we are getting the value of q into g of x. This q we don't know. Okay. So this is the differentiation of two for first function, differentiation of second function plus second function, differentiation of first function. And from left hand to right hand side, we are going to compare the coefficient of y. So p into g of x is equal to g dash x. P is equal to g dash 1 g of x. Integrating on both sides. So integration of p dx is equal to integration of it. G of x is equal to t. And g of x is equal to t. Then differentiation of it, g dash x dx is equal to dt. So it is 1 upon t dt log t. P dx is equal to log t. From the logarithmic form to convert into the exponential form, e to the power p dx is equal to gx. The value of gx will be replaced in equation number 1. So we are getting this term. And actually this is the expansion of, actually it is the used product rule in the two functions. So there are two functions in which a product differentiation product rule is applied here. So I have written here dy dx, y into dy dx. Integrating on both sides. When we integrate the term, then the differentiation will be removed from here. So integration has been done, and integration, because here we have not done integration, so integration sign and dx plus constant term. Okay, so you remember it. If dy by dx plus py is equal to q is there, then what should be done? Y into e to the power x, y into e to the power p dx is equal to integration e to the power p dx qx dx plus c. And what is e to the power p dx? That is integrating factor, is known as if. Okay, integrating factor. So now we are starting exercise 9.6. Two formulae you should remember. First, we'll have to check it whether it is a linear differential equation, yes or no. If yes, then we can use this formula directly. Okay. Taking question number one. Question number one is 9.6 exercise. First question, dy dx plus 2y is equal to sin x. I told you the value of p and q which contains x, variable x. If there's no variable, then only constant, but there should not be y here. Okay, so remember this. So this is linear differential equation. We can compare it by dy by dx plus py is equal to q. P is equal to 2 and q is equal to sin x. Is that okay? Right. Formula for integrating factor y e to the power p dx is equal to integration of q into e to the power p dx dx plus c. This is the formula which would be used here. But first of all, we are going to find the integrating factor. What is it? Integrating factor. The name is IF. Integrating factor. E to the power p dx. E to the power p. What is p? 2 and dx. So the result is e to the power 2x. Okay. So integrating factor e to the power 2x. Put the value here. Y into e to the power 2x is equal to q sin x into e to the power 2x dx plus c. Okay, now I'll simplify this term. Sin x into e to the power 2x, you can give this as equation number 1. Now let I is equal to e to the power 2x into sin x dx. Okay, it's taking as a equation number. This I have given as equation number 1. This I is equal to e to the power 2x e to the power sin x dx. It is 2. Okay. Now what should be done here? Using integration by part. Okay. First function, integration of second function. So first function e to the power 2x. Integration of sin x minus cos x minus. Differentiation of e to the power 2x. E to the power 2x into 2. And integration of sin x minus cos x. That which is plus cos x dx. Again, I is equal to minus e to the power 2x cos x plus 2. And again, using by parts, first function e to the power 2x, integration of cos x sin x minus differentiation of e to the power 2x e to the power 2x into 2 and integration of cos x sin x dx. Is that okay? So that means it is I is equal to minus e to the power 2x cos x plus 2 e to the power 2x sin x plus 2 e to the power 2x sin x. This is plus minus minus 4 plus minus minus 4. And what is it? It is I. Clear? Because this 2 is outside, so this 2 will be multiplied both sides, which is minus 4. Minus 4i is coming here. So it is 5i is equal to minus e to the power 2x cos x plus 2e to the power 2x sin x. Therefore, I is equal to 1 upon 5. And may I take e to the power 2x common, then what is here? E to the power 2x common, so it is 2 sin x minus cos x. Okay, right? So this is the value of that term. Now by 1. By 1. First equation is this here, y into e to the power 2x is equal to, what is the answer of this term? E to the power 2x upon 5, 2 sin x minus cos x plus c. Okay. Therefore, what is the value of y? Y is equal to, I will take e to the power 2x to be divide. So this is 1 2x cancel, 1 upon 5, 2 sin x minus cos x plus c e to the power 2x divided e to the power minus 2x. So that is the value of y. Okay, this is the value of y. Let us check the answer from answer sheet. What is there? Y is equal to 1 upon 5, 2 sin x minus cos x, c e to the power minus 2x. Exact same. Okay. So that is the solution of question number 1. So in this entire exercise, first we'll have to check whether it is a linear differential equation, yes or no. If yes, then simply use the formula and find the value. Okay. Find the value of y or the value of x. Okay. And now I want to take question from this exercise. From 9.6, I am taking a question. Second, third. Okay. Third question, may I take it? Dy by dx plus y upon x is equal to x square. Is equal to x square. Okay. We will compare this y. Dy by dx plus py is equal to q. So p is equal to what is it? 1 upon x, and q is equal to x square. First we'll have to find integrating factor, e to the power p dx. What is it? E to the power p is 1 upon x dx. Okay. So e to the power, the integration of 1 upon x is log x. E to the power log x, the value is 1. E to the power log x is equal to x. Okay. Let me tell you how it is coming. E to the power log x is equal to x. See, e to the power log x is equal to x. We are going to verify it, whether it is true or not true. So for verifying it, what should be done? This exponential form to be converted to the form of logarithmic form. So what should I write here? Log e to the power x is equal to log x. Log x is equal to log x. Okay, so verified. So e to the power log x is equal to x. Now formula, y e to the power p dx is equal to e to the power p dx into q dx plus c. Okay, y e to the power p dx x is equal to e to the power p dx x into q. The value of q is x square dx plus c. So y into x is equal to x cube dx plus c. Therefore y into x is equal to x to the power 4 upon 4 plus c. So divide by x, y is equal to x cube upon 4 plus c x to the power minus. Okay, so this is the value of y. Got it? So the questions of the same type, one trigonometric type question. I am taking question number 5, fifth question. What is question number 5th? Fifth is, cos square x dy by dx cos square x dy by dx plus y is equal to 10x plus y is equal to 10x and the value of x between 0 to pi by 2. Okay. So with dy by dx, you know that the standard form dy by dx plus py is equal to q. So first this cos square x will be divided. So dy by dx plus y, cos square x to be written in the form of sec square x is equal to 10x into sec square x. Because cos square x divided by, so y upon cos square x, it is sec square x. Cos is a reciprocal of sec, and upon cos sec square x. Okay. So what is P? Sec square x. And what is Q? 10x into sec square x. Okay. Formula y into e to the power p dx is equal to e to the power p dx into q dx plus c. So we are finding first integrating factor. What is it? E to the power p. What is the value of p? Sec square x dx. Okay. Sec square x dx. Integration of sec square x is 10x. So what is it? E to the power 10x. This is integrating factor. Okay. May I put the value here? Y into e to the power p dx. E to the power 10x is equal to e to the power 10x into q. Q, that means it is the value of q is 10x into 10x into sec square x dx plus c. Okay. So y into e to the power 10x is equal to, what should I take here? Let 10x is equal to t sec square x dx be dt. Okay. So here I can take let 10x is equal to t, then sec square x dx is equal to dt. Okay. So what is this term? This term will be e to the power t, e to the power t, and sec square x dx dt into t, it is dt plus c. Am I right? E to the power t, 10x t, and sec square x dx dt. Okay, there are two functions, first function, second function. E to the power 10x is equal to, using by parts, first function t, integration of e to the power t, same as minus differentiation of t. That is one. Differentiation, that is one. And again integration, that e to the power t. Is that okay? First function, integration of second function, minus differentiation of t, one, and integration of e to the power t. Is it okay? Now I will put the value later on. Y is into e to the power 10x is equal to e to the power t. It is t minus 1 plus c. Now when I put the value of t, is equal to 10x, then let us see what is y into the e to the power 10x is equal to e to the power 10x 10x minus 1 plus c. We'll divide by e to the power 10x. So y is equal to e to the power 10x, cancel. 10x minus 1 plus c and e to the power minus 10x. Is it okay? Now let us see our answer is correct or not. This is question number 5th. 9.6 question number, y is equal to 10x. See, y is equal to 10x minus 1 plus c e to the power minus 10x. Exact same. Okay. So what I have done here, this value I have not substituted here. First I will solve it completely and then put the value. And my suggestion, I think you should do the same. Okay. It saves your time also and accurate calculation. So in other questions of the same exercise 9.6, I think the same pattern we have to follow. All our linear differential equation, all our linear differential equation, and we'll put the value in the formula. Okay. Up to question number 12. One more. From this page, I want to take question number 8. Question number 8. 1 plus x square dy plus 2xy dx is equal to cot x is equal to cot x, okay, dx. cot x dx. Okay. 1 plus x square dy plus 2xy dx is equal to cot x dx. Clear? 1 plus x square dy is equal to dx. May I write here cot x minus 2xy and it is dx. Is that okay? First of all, I am writing dy by dx. And let us see which condition is there. Dy by dx is equal to cot x minus 2xy upon 1 plus x square. Clear? Okay. So dy by dx, converting into the form of linear differential equation. So this is plus 2xy upon 1 plus x square is equal to cot x upon 1 plus x square. Is that okay? Cot x upon 1 plus x square minus 2xy upon 1 plus x square. This minus 2xy will be shifted here. Plus 2xy upon 1 plus x square is equal to cot x upon 1 plus x square. Because the standard linear differential equation is dy by dx plus py is equal to q. This is the y. Other terms are having only x, our constant term. And that is purely based on x terms. Okay. So now we'll compare by general linear equation. So p is equal to 2x upon 1 plus x square, giving this y, coefficient of y. And q is equal to cot x upon 1 plus x square. Okay. For finding integrating factor, e to the power p dx. E to the power, what is p? 2x upon 1 plus x square dx. Okay. How to solve it? 1 plus x square is equal to t. 2x dx is equal to dt. So it is 1 upon t. So when I write here e to the power 1 upon t. Log 1 plus x square. Is it okay? See, this is the simplification. 1 plus x square is equal to t. 2x dx is equal to dt. So this is e to the power 2x dx dt 1 upon t dt. So it is e to the power log t. And the value of t is 1 plus x square. And e to the power log x is equal to x. Therefore, direct 1 plus x square. What is it? It is integrating factor. Okay. Formula y into integrating factor. If is equal to integrating factor into qx dx or e to the power p dx. Same thing. So y integrating factor 1 plus x square. 1 plus x square. And what is the value of q? The value of q is cot x upon 1 plus x square. Dx plus c. So this 1 plus x square cancel. Y into 1 plus x square is equal to integration of cot x. Integration of cot x is log sin x. Plus c. Okay. Log sin x plus c. Because cot x can be written cos x upon sin x is equal to t, cos x dx dt 1 upon t log sin x. Okay. So therefore y is equal to log sin x upon 1 plus x square plus c upon 1 plus x square. Okay. So this is the value of y. Okay. Now let us see the answer is given in which format. It is question number 8. Question number 8. 8 answer y is equal to 1 plus x log sin x plus c 1 plus x square minus 1. 1 plus x log sin x upon 1 plus x is there. No, it is 1 plus x square. It is my mistake. 1 plus x only there. This is 1 plus x square. Because when we divide by 1 plus x square, then the term is coming 1 plus x square only. And here also c 1 plus x square to the power minus 2 is given. So that is 2. 1 plus x square will be coming here. Here it is mentioned only 1 plus x. Okay. So that is a mistake from the book side. So that is the answer of it. Because integrating factor is 1 plus x square, so we have to divide by 1 plus x square, will not divide by 1 plus x. Okay, so that is the answer of this. only in place of x square everything is same as they have written c 1 plus x square to the power minus 1. Okay, so from the denominator it is shifted to numerator. Now turning the page of this book, and we are taking a question. One question I want to take, number 9. I am finding a question, x dy by dx plus y minus x plus xy cot x is equal to 0. Ninth question, x dy by dx plus y minus x plus xy cot x is equal to 0. Okay, cot x is equal to 0. So with dy by dx there is a x, so first we'll have to divide by x. Dy by dx plus y upon x minus cancel 1 plus x cancel y cot x is equal to 0. Okay, here what should be done, the term having y, so dy by dx plus, may I take y common from these two terms, so it is coming 1 upon x plus cot x is equal to 1. Is that clear? Dy by dx plus y, 1 upon x plus cot x is equal to 1, and this can be compared by the standard differential linear equation, dy by dx plus py is equal to q. Py, what is the value of P? One plus x cot x upon x is equal to 1. Okay. All right. So what is P? 1 plus x cot x upon x. And Q is equal to 1 only. Integrating factor, I have e to the power p dx, e to the power 1 plus x cot x upon x dx. Okay. So now we'll integrate this term and let us see what is the result is coming. Simply 1 upon x plus cot x, I can write it. Okay. So integration of 1 upon x. Integration of 1 upon x is log x plus integration of cot x log sin x. Okay, log x plus log sin x. So it is coming e to the power log x into sin x, log m plus log n, log m into n. Log e to the power log x, that means it is x sin x. Okay, so what should I write here? Direct x sin x. Okay, what is it? It is integrating factor. E to the power log x is equal to x, therefore x sin x. Right? X sin x. Now formula y into integrating factor. X sin x is equal to integrating factor x sin x into the value of q is equal to 1 dx plus c. So y into x sin x is equal to x sin x. Product rule, first function, violate first algebraic expression, after that trigonometry. Okay. So this is first function, integration of sin x minus cos x minus differentiation of x, that is 1, integration of sin x minus cos x. So it is plus cos x dx plus c. So that means it is y into x sin x is equal to minus x cos x, and again integration of cos x is sin x plus sin x. And plus c. Okay, so therefore the value of y is equal to where divide by x sin x. So what is this? X x cancel minus cos x upon sin x. It is cot x plus this is only cos x. What is coming here? Sin x. Sin x cancel 1 upon x plus c upon x sin x. Okay, so that is the value of y. Now let us check its answer is given in which format. 1 upon x minus cot x plus c upon x sin x. Exact same. Okay, clear? One more question from these questions up to 12, and that question I want to take. This is number 11. Y dx plus x minus y square dy is equal to 0. Okay, so as usual we'll have to check it dy by dx first. Y dx is equal to minus x minus y square dy. So dy by dx is equal to minus y upon x minus y square. Is that okay? Dy by dx is equal to minus y upon x minus y whole is minus sign is here. Okay, but here what's happening, see, y upon x minus y whole square, this cannot be separated, but in place of this it could be x minus y square upon y, then you can separate easily. So in place of dy by dx we have to convert into the form of dx by dy. So if it is dx by dy, then what happens? X minus y square upon minus y. Is that okay? So that means dx upon dy is equal to minus x upon y and plus y square upon y, that means it is y, right? And that is the form of dx upon dy plus px is equal to q. Here this term is in the form of, here x is only 1, this is in the form of y, r coefficient, and that is in the form of y. Okay, so that's okay. dx by dy plus x upon y is equal to y. P is equal to 1 upon y and q is equal to y. Integrating factor e to the power, what is p dy this time? So p is 1 upon y dy. 1 upon y, that means log y. So e to the power log y, that is y. So this is integrating factor. Okay, and its formula is x into integrating factor is equal to integrating factor into q dy plus c. Okay, x as it is, what is integrating factor? That is y, is equal to integrating factor y, and the value of q is y dy plus c. So x into y is equal to y square, so y cube upon 3 plus c. Okay, divide by y, because here we are finding the value of x. So x is equal to y square upon 3 plus c y inverse. This is the value of x. Okay, everything is same as, only in place of dy by dx the format is dx by dy. X is equal to y cube upon 3 plus c upon y. Okay, here in the book it is given that c upon y, I have written c upon y, cy inverse, same thing. Okay, Okay, so up to question number 12 the same, and now we are coming on the particular solutions from 13-2 up to 18 question. 13th question I am taking, we are finding the particular solution, same procedure dy by dx plus 2y tan x is equal to sin x, and condition is given when y is equal to 0, when x is equal to pi by 3. Okay, the question is for each of the following difference equation, find a particular solution satisfying the given condition. Y is equal to 0 and x is equal to pi by 2. Dy dx plus 2y tan x is equal to sin x. Okay, is equal to sin x. Alright, so simple equation is given. Dy by dx plus py is equal to q. P is equal to 2 tan x. And q is equal to sin x. Okay. We are finding integrating factor if, that is e to the power p dx, e to the power p 2 tan x dx, e to the power 2, and integration of tan x is minus log cos x. So I write here minus log cos x, e to the power log, I write here cos x to the power minus 2. This minus 2 power will be shifted here as per the rule of log. So e to the power log x, that is x. So that means direct it is cos x to the power minus 1 by 2. That means 1 upon cos x square. Is it okay? And cos x whole square, that means cos square x. Same thing. Cos x whole square or cos square x. No change. So now y integrating factor is equal to integrating factor q dx plus c. Okay, so y into integrating factor 1 upon cos square x, 1 upon cos square x into q, the value of q is sin x dx. Okay, the value of q is sin x dx. So now when I take cos x is equal to t, cos x is equal to t minus sin x dx is equal to dt. Therefore, sin x dx is equal to minus dt. Okay. So, what is this? Y into 1 upon cos square x is equal to cos x is equal to t, 1 upon t square, and sin x dx minus dt plus c. So, y into 1 upon cos square x is equal to minus 1 upon t square, t to the power minus 2, minus 2 plus 1, minus 1 upon minus 1. So may I write here 1 upon t direct plus c. So y into 1 upon cos square x is equal to 1 upon what is t, cos x, and plus c. Now from this equation we are finding the value of c. Okay, so y is equal to 0, when I put y is equal to 0 and x is equal to pi by 3. So when I put y is equal to 0, this entire term is 0, is equal to 1 upon cos pi by 3 plus c. Cos pi by 3, cos 60, the value of cos 60 is 1 by 2. So 1 upon 1 by 2, it is 2. So 2 plus c is equal to 0, c is equal to minus 2. Now by 1, y into 1 upon cos square x is equal to 1 upon cos x minus 2. Okay, so we multiplied by cos square x. So y is equal to cos square upon cos x, that is cos x minus 2 cos square x. Okay, y is equal to cos x minus 2 cos square x, cos x common, 1 minus 2 cos x. Clear? Question number 13th, y is equal to cos x minus 2 cos square x. Clear? Okay. So these are the particular solutions in which only we have to put the value of c, finding the value of c, putting the value in place of x and y, and then this general solution will be converted into the form of particular solution. Okay. One more question I want to take, 15th, and then two questions I'll explain you. 15th question is dy by dx minus 3y cot x is equal to sin 2x. Y is equal to given 2, x is equal to pi by 2. Y is equal to 2, x is equal to pi by 2. Okay. Y is equal to 2 when x is equal to pi by 2. When x pi by 2, then y is equal to 2. Okay. General form given, what is p? P is equal to minus 3 cot x, coefficient of y minus 3 cot x. Q is equal to sine 2x. Okay. Integrating factor, e to the power p dx, e to the power p minus 3 cot x dx, e to the power minus 3 cot x log sin x, integration of cot x is log sin x. So this minus 3 will be shifted here. So I write here 1 upon sin x whole cube, minus 3 will be coming here, sin x to the power minus 3. So 1 upon sin x whole cube or sin cube x, same thing. Okay, formula, y into integrating factor is equal to integrating factor into q dx plus c. So y integrating factor 1 upon sin cube x is equal to 1 upon sin cube x into q, that is sin 2x dx plus c. Okay. How to integrate this? Y into 1 upon sin cube x is equal to, may I write sin 2x, 2 sin x into cos x? Upon sin cube x dx. Is it okay? Let us consider that sin x is equal to t. Sin x is equal to t. Then cos x dx is equal to dt. Okay. By the way, we can do one thing. Sin square is here. One sin is cancelled, so it is cos x square x into cot x. But listen, sin x is equal to t, cos x dx dt. So it is y into 1 upon sin cube x is equal to, this is 2, and sin x is equal to t. So sin x is equal to t cos x dx, cos x dx dt. So I write here t dt, sorry, sin x t and cos x dx dt upon t cube. Okay, so y into 1 upon sin cube t, so sin cube x is equal to 2, dt cancel, 1 upon t square, t to the power minus 2 dt plus c. Next step, y into 1 upon sin cube x is equal to 2, t to the power minus 2 plus 1 minus 1, t to the power minus 1 upon minus 1, so minus 1 upon t plus c. Okay, so y into 1 upon sin cube x is equal to minus 2 upon t sin x plus c. So therefore, y is equal to sin cube x will be multiplied here. So minus 2 sin square x, 1 sin x cancel, and plus sin cube x. Here, one thing also, that is, we put the value of c. Here I can put the value c in equation number 1, y1. Y is equal to 2, x is equal to pi by 2. Y is equal to 2, so here I'll put 2. into 1 upon sine 90, and the value of sine 90 is 1, is equal to minus 2 upon sine 90 is 1 plus c. Okay, so therefore the value of c is equal to 2 1 ja 2 and plus 2 4. The value of c is equal to 4. Therefore final answer is y is equal to minus 2 sine square x plus 4 sine cube x. Okay, so here when I take 2 sine square x common, if I take 2 sine square x common, so it is 2 sine x minus 1. Okay, y is equal to 2 sine square x, 2 sine x minus 1. Okay, let us see the answer is given in which format. That is question number 15. Y is equal to 4 sine cube x, 4 sine cube x minus 2 sine square x. Answer is given only, y is equal to 4 sine cube x minus 2 sine square x. That is the answer given in the book. Okay, clear? So that is one. Two more questions are given. These are the words problem. Let me discuss with you. Now there are two questions, number 16th and 17th. These are the word problem. Find the equation of the curve passing through the origin, given that the slope of the tangent to the curve at a point xy is equal to the sum of the coordinates of the point. Tangent is equal to sum of the coordinate of the point. So in 16th question, what is this? Tangent means slope, dy by dx is equal to sum of the coordinate. It is given. This is the equation. Slope is equal to the sum of the coordinates of the point, and this is passing through the point origin. So that means they are asking the particular solution. You will solve it. After that, x is equal to 0 and y is equal to 0. I'm getting the particular solution. I hope you will solve this. Again, using dy by dx, shift this term minus x is equal, sorry, minus y is equal to x, like this. Dy by dx minus y is equal to x. P is equal to minus 1, q is equal to x. Now y integrating factor is equal to integrating factor into q dx plus c. Okay, hope you can solve this. Try to solve it. 17th, find the equation of the curve passing through the point 0 comma 2. It is passing through 0 comma 2. Given that the sum of the coordinates of the point on the curve exceeds the magnitude of the slope of tangent to the curve at the point by 5. What is the line? Curve, it is given that the sum of the coordinates of any point on the curve exceeds the magnitude by 5. Sum. So x plus y exceeds the magnitude of slope by 5. Okay, this is the condition. Sum of the coordinate exceeds the magnitude of slope by 5. That means the difference between them is equal to 5. So that means x plus y minus 5 is equal to dy by dx. Okay, now you have understood dy by dx minus y is equal to x minus 5. P is equal to minus 1, Q is equal to x minus 5. And the point x is equal to 0 and y is equal to 2 given. Okay. So I hope you will solve these questions. Two NCQs are given, the integrating factor of the differential equation. Generally the question is asked in 1 mark, what is the integrating factor of it? So dy dx is equal minus y upon x, minus 1 upon x is there. Okay, let us discuss this also. Because this question generally in boards it asks the find the integrating factor of the differential linear equation. X dy by dx minus y is equal to 2x. So dy by dx minus y upon x is equal to 2x. Okay, divide by. So p is equal to minus 1 upon x, integrating factor 1 upon x dx with minus sign. Log x e to the power minus log x. So minus 1, 1 upon x. So the integrating factor of it is 1 upon x, not x. Remember it. Because this minus 1 will be shifted here. Okay. Again, find the integrating factor of that. So this is dy by dx by dy, y upon x. One more question, number 19 also I'll discuss. Dx by dy plus y upon plus yx upon 1 minus y square is equal to ay upon 1 minus y square. So here what is the integrating factor now? Y upon 1 minus y square. So e to the power y upon 1 minus y square dy. What is its integrating factor? 1 minus y square is equal to t minus 2y dy is equal to dt. Therefore, y dy is equal to minus 1 upon 2 dt. So e to the power minus 1 upon 2, 1 upon t dt. So e to the power log t and minus 1 upon 2 power is here. So e to the power log t to the power minus 1 by 2. And what is t we have considered? We have considered 1 minus y square. So 1 upon under root t. And 1 upon under root 1 minus y square will be integrating factor. 1 upon under root 1 minus y square, option D is the correct. Okay. So that's all. This is the exercise based on linear differential equations. Okay. I hope you enjoyed with this exercise. Keep practicing of solving the questions. Okay. So in my next lecture, we'll have to discuss about the miscellaneous exercise. Till then, bye. Thank you.